So, as you know, that thank you for coming tonight and to help you to realize that meditation is very important subject for us to able to get an idea what we need to do during daily life. So nowadays, as you know, that we live in a world with stress, anxiety, fear. All those stuff arise in ourselves, right? During this COVID season, right? So the topic today I'd like to share with you that peace of mind in our daily life. So what does it mean? That the mean is that our mind is always at peace in our daily life, right? So during daily life, as you know, that we live 24 hours a day. But we spend most of our time sleeping about 7 or 8 hours, right? So what about the other 16 hours? What we do? We working, eating, sleeping, driving, playing, right? So as you know, that the statement say that our mind is like a monkey, right? And our thinking like a horse. As you know, our mind is like a monkey. What does it mean? That our mind is like a monkey. It's right, like you're chasing around everything, right? Chasing here and there, always thinking, never stop, right? That is the true nature of our mind. It's always thinking. And our thinking mind is like a horse. It's always running. So the mind we use in our daily life is that thinking mind, right? So sometimes we overthinking. We have too much thinking, that's why we have stress, anxiety, fear, right? So how can we able to relax our mind, right? Sometimes our mind is working too hard, right? Nowadays we work a lot, our mind think too much because we have a lot of material, right? A lot of thing that our society makes us stress, anxiety, fear. So meditation is a way to help you to calm down, right? Try to relax your mind. Because sometimes we need our mind to be rest, right? You see, our body is working so hard, sometimes we need to sleep, we need to rest our body. But our mind is like that. Our mind is like working 24 hours a day, right? Your body can work only a couple of days, couple of hours, and then you rest, you lie down and rest. But our mind, during our sleep, is also working, right? So a meditation method is help you to calm and to rest your mind. So how can we do rest our mind? The first method is that we follow our breath. The breathing is very important, right? So whenever you're thinking a lot, anxiety, fear, just go back to your breath. Because the breathing help you to realize how our mind is thinking and observe the thinking, right? So our mind is like a monkey. So we need something to stop our monkey, right? We need a banana, is something that help the monkey to stop chasing, running around. So we need meditation to stop our thinking, or we call less thinking, right? So every day we live with this mind, what we call a monkey mind, right? But actually this peace of mind in our daily life we use is already there 24 hours. So we observe the peace of our mind in every moment. Even though during our turbulent day, that peace of mind is already there. So I want you to recognize that our mind is already at peace. It's already at rest. But we don't realize that. Just like the space, you see the space? Is the space always resting or moving? Some people moving, some they resting. the space always resting, right? But the earth is moving, right? So our mind is like space, it's always resting. But our thinking mind is like the earth, the material, is always moving. So our nature mind is always at peace, it's always at rest, like space. But our thinking mind is like a monkey, like the house, the sound, the wind is always moving, right? So I give example like thinking mind like the wind, the storm, the cloud, the house, the car. Everything is impermanent, everything is moving, changing, right? But the space never change. So our true nature of our mind is like that, like space. So when you observe your inner peace, the peace of mind, during your daily life, you already have that peaceful mind, right? So that's why we have to recognize that we already at peace all the time, that we just forgot, we just forgetting our peaceful mind, right? So how do we know that? By quiet your mind, sitting without talking, without telephone, without any working, and then you observe, right? Sometimes we chopping the vegetable, sometimes we cooking, washing the dish. We observe clearly that our mind is at rest. If our mind is not at rest, then we cannot see our thinking mind. So in our tradition, Zen tradition, we divide these two kind of mind. It's called thinking mind and non-thinking mind. So the non-thinking mind is like the space, and thinking mind is like the material, phenomena, the earth, the water, the wind, everything is just moving, changing, right? But the space is stillness. So our non-thinking mind is always stillness, at peace with ourselves, within ourselves. So I want you to observe during your practice in your daily life that even though you have stress, anxiety, fear, restlessness, but that peace is already there. So that's why one of the Buddha's statements say that our mind is the main factor for running up our action. That our mind is the factor, is the forerunner of our action. Whatever you do, saying, talking, listening, observing, that is depend on our mind, right? So we have this body, painful, emotion, whatever emotion you have in your body through your mind, right? So you observe that peaceful during you sitting here. Even though you're sitting here with calm and quiet, but you observe your mind is always thinking, right? At home, you are too busy. You don't have enough of energy to sit stillness. But when you come to a meditation center, you put all your effort, right? All your mind follow with a guiding teacher and with a people around you, your follower, come and sit and observe this peaceful state. So the peaceful state is come from your inner mind. So that energy come from your inner mind that's able to help each other out. Just like if you stay in an environment with peace and calmness environment, you can able to feel it. But if you go to a place that a lot of turbulent, a lot of toxic, a lot of poison, you can feel that energy, what we call negative energy, right? So the environment you live in is very important, right? Just like if you sit meditation at the market, in the mall, can you sit stillness for 5 or 10 minutes? It's very difficult, right? Because a lot of noise, music, people go around, right? It's turbulent. But when you come to a meditation center, you sit with calmness and stillness, you can feel that positive energy, right? So through your mind, you see that there's turbulent and there's non-turbulent. But that peace of mind is always there. Even though you sit in the market, your peace of mind is already there. You just change in the environment outside, right? If you come here, it's the same thing, because the environment that help you nurture your stillness mind, right? So for beginner meditator, they need to find a place that are quiet, peaceful, calmness to begin, right? But when you get used to it, your mind at state of restlessness, you can go anywhere. You can meditate any place. Just like in the market, in the noisy environment, during the sport game, you can meditate. Like if you ever watch football, basketball, go to the basketball game or football game or baseball game, you can sit there and meditate, even though that noisy, right? That is advantage stillness already. But for beginner, you need a place that calm and peace, right? So the peaceful of mind in our daily life we use, that is stillness that you already have it. So you try to observe what you're doing. It's like when you're driving, you observe you are driving. When you are cooking, you observe you are cooking. When you're saying something, speaking, you observe that what you're saying. So everything that relate to our mind. When we are mindfulness, when we are mindful, we speak and say and listen with deep understanding, right? Deep compassion. But if you speaking, saying, make some kind of action without angry, frustrated mind, that will not good, right? So you can tell from the bottom of your heart, you can do with angry mind, frustrated mind, stressed mind, restlessness mind, the result will not good. But if you use your stillness, mindfulness, understanding, love, compassion, mind to do it, then the result is good. So all the good result or bad result depend on the state of mind in the moment you have, right? It's like right now you are peaceful and calm and peace, you drive, you feel safe. But when you drive with anxiety, fear, restlessness, right? Your driving is not very good. So that's why we have to be patient with our mind, right? So whatever you do the whole week for yourself, you have to observe worry, fear, stress, anxiety, all this arise, emotion arise in your mind. And you try to observe what I need to do, right? So the problem is that we have to handle the situation that problem will come, right? When we are able to understand the problem, then we can solve it easily. We can deal with it easily. So I hope you use this peace of mind in your daily life to practice. Not wait until you come here and learn the method and go home and practice. But the main thing is that we have to know what we're doing, right? And then when we practice method, what is the result, right? Because everything you want to do is there's a cause and consequence. You want to get a good, healthy result, then practice the right method. If you practice the wrong method, then the result will not very good. So as you know, that through practice, peaceful meditation, you will get the good result by observing your mind, by saying, listening, talking, walking, whatever you do, right? You can try this at your work, at your home, or the environment, what you live in, right? So I hope you are able to understand the peace of mind is always with you, right? Just like, have you ever watch Star Wars? Anybody watch Star Wars here? The Force is already with you, right? It's like that. The peace of mind is already within you, right? So that's why the Star Wars is like the Force is within you, right? The Force is the energy, the stillness of mind. If you're able to use this mind, you can do anything, right? Because your mind can be used with very strong. It's like when a person with a strong mind, they can control the environment around, right? So that's why you have to enjoy what you have in the moment. Fortunately, we live in a country with peace and calm, understanding, love, compassion. Use that, right? So you can enjoy this inner peace at work, at your home, anywhere, right? So that is very essential for us to realize that we have inner peace is part of our life, right? So try to generate this energy, try to get more positive energy. Just like for a beginner meditator, they need more positive energy. If you deal with a lot of negative energy, then will affect your mind, right? So you have to choose, is this good for me or bad for me? Is good for me, I continue to do it. Is bad, then I will stop. Just like a friend, a family, or a coworker, whoever might you have grouchy, upset, anxiety, fear, we need to stop. We need to see, oh, wait a minute, I need to change, right? So whoever bring you with love, compassion, understanding, right, solve the problem well, then continue. So that is very essential for us to use this peaceful mind in our daily life. So for my experiment, that I use this peaceful mind every day. Just like at the monastery, every day is the same. Monday to Sunday, we eat, we sleep, we meditate, we chanting, we do the garden. So every moment I do, I just observe my mind, and then what my mind is doing, right? What my mind is thinking, right? So when you observe your mind in the moment, then you do everything clearly. You understand the environment around you, right? You understand the condition around you. So when a person with deep understanding, deep alert, deep wisdom, that he or she do with mindfulness, right? Do with wellness. But if your mind with anxiety, fear, stress, worry, then you do the thing around you will be have a bad consequence, right? So you can do this by yourself, practice by yourself. So I hope you can able to do with your peaceful. Even though we don't have a peaceful day, we have a problem in our life, but we can convert that, right, to the peaceful mind that we have. Because as you know, that life very short. The problem you have, it will come and go. It will not stay with you forever, right? So that is important. Even though you have a bad day in your life, that bad day is what? It's gone, it's the past, right? So enjoy each moment in your life. Because this moment you cannot fight back, right? So I hope you to realize that all the suffer, all the stress, all the anxiety is come from this self, what we call this ego. We attach to this self, that's why we have a lot of suffering. So if you let go of this self, this ego, right, then you have no more suffering. So that's why the Buddha say, when you see with your wisdom that all come phenomena without self, then there's no more suffering. We have suffering because we attachment to this self, this ego, right? It's everything's mine. That's why we have the suffering. So if you let go of this I, this mine, then you have less suffering, right? For example, if you just bought a new, what we call the iPad, right? But you attach to it, somebody touch it, you get grouchy, upset, right? But if you don't attach to it, you just use it, then you don't feel stressed out, feel anxiety, feel fear, right? And because we think that this is mine. If you see this material is for everyone, everyone can use it, then you will be happy. But if you say, oh, this is mine, you attach to your ego, yourself, then whoever use it, then you get upset. You see what I'm saying? So just like from the iPad to iPhone, to the car, to the house, to material you have, it's just a temporary. We just use, borrow. You can borrow this couple of years, right? And then you have to sell it, or sometimes you throw away. It's like a lot of people, when they first have their own iPhone, they're so happy. But they use it a couple of years, and then what? They just throw here and there. They don't care anymore. Everything, your first time, you feel like treasure. You feel like you hold it in your hand all the time. But once you get used to it, you know that's yours, and then you get you don't like anymore, right? Then you throw around, right? And then we buy a new one. So that's why that's we attachment, this ego, this self, this material, right? So all the suffering that we create for ourselves is our ego, right? So if you're able to let go of this ego, this self, then you have a peaceful mind every day, right? Every moment. So that's why the peaceful mind or the affliction mind or the turbulent mind is depend on you, right? So everything depends on you right now. You want to be peace, then be peace yourself. If you don't want to be peace, then you can make turbulent, right? You have to choose your own material, right? So I hope you can use this daily life, peaceful mind, to practice during your turbulent life, during your bad day or good day, right? Sometimes we have good day, sometimes we have bad day. But when the good day come, we feel very great, right? We feel like magic. But when bad thing come, bad luck come, or bad day come, we feel like we are the worst, or we are down bottom. That's why we have let go of this negative thought. So I hope you try to generate a lot of positive thought in your mind, because you know that life, you have a wonderful around you. You have air, clean air, clean environment, a beautiful flower, there's the sun, there's water. Lucky we live in Jacksonville, we have beach. Drive to the beach and observe how wonderful thing it is, right? So I hope you enjoy your life each moment. Don't waste your life, right? Because bad things come and go, good things come and go. It's everything impermanent. So when you observe everything impermanent, then there's peace, right? There's calmness, there's stillness, there's compassion, there's love, loving kindness. So that's why we live in this environment, that we can find peace. Peace is not far away, but peace is the state of mind that in your heart, in yourself, that's where you can find. So peace is at home. You cannot travel around the world and find peace. You can travel around the world and find money, find treasure, find this and that, but you cannot find peace. Peace is in your moment, in the here and the now, not somewhere else. So I hope you, when you live in a state of mind, peacefulness, you have overcome craving, stress, anxiety, confused, greed, aggressive. All this state of mind, you will overcome it, right? So don't worry. This is a song say, don't worry, be what? Be happy, right? There's a lot of musicians, they able to create a song like, make you happy all the time, but don't worry. Because everything will come and go. Everything is changing, impermanent. So I hope you, when you wake up, you enjoy your each moment. You enjoy your coffee, you enjoy your water, you enjoy your tea, whatever you drink in the morning. Enjoy your breakfast, enjoy that moment, right? Because that moment will never come again, right? Every day is not the same. Every day is different, right? So that, just like today, Friday, October the 8th, 2021. This day will not come again. This hour will not come again. So you enjoy this moment, right? So next Friday will be next day, right? So that's why I hope you enjoy every moment of your life and to be generate positive energy, because life is very short. We can, just like today, Friday, we can see each other, but next Friday, I might not here. I might die, or you might die, right? Impermanent, right? So you see the impermanent, then we respect each moment that we have, right? So that's why we have to use our peaceful mind to generate this positive energy, right? So this is the topic I try to share with you, peace of mind in our daily life, in the moment that we live, in the society that we live. So generate that positive energy. So all the stress, anxiety, fear, whatever you have, it will wash away. Just like when we have our body have a lot of dirt, we have to use a lot of water to wash it out. So like we have a lot of negative anxiety, fear, stress, desire, craving, then we use the meditation method. It's like water that's able to wash all this away, clean yourself off. So that's why we meditate every day is to wash our mind. Because our minds can be good thought, bad thought, anxiety thought, it's a lot of things. So that's why as a Buddhist monk, we have to wake up 3 in the morning, we sit meditation 2 hours and wash our mind and observe our mind. And then before we go to sleep, we meditate another hour, 2 hours to wash our mind. So every day you wash your mind, sooner or later your mind will be clean. Just like our body. Imagine you start washing your body a couple of days, couple of weeks, couple of months. That's very smell, right? It's like our mind is the same thing. Our mind have a lot of trash, a lot of negative thought. So I hope you come every Friday, we can come together and sit and observe our mind and wash. Because you can wash at home, but sometimes we wash by ourselves, we don't have the good energy. So if you come to with a group of people meditate, we can generate this positive energy. So that energy can help us or generate to wash ourselves. Sometimes the environment is very important, right? So I hope you at home or at here, you can wash your mind every moment, every second, every hour, and observe your well-being, right? And enjoy each moment of your life, right? So do you have any question, comment, anything that you like to share from your daily life, or anything that difficult in your life? Everything perfect, right? So I hope you to enjoy each moment of your life, and I hope you continue to meditate at home. You can spend for 5 or 10 minutes, meditate and observe your mind before you go sleep. And then before you go to work, just sit for 5 or 10 minutes and observe your mind. But the more you meditate, the more you wash your mind, right? The more at peace yourself. So I help you generate this energy with you, right? This peace of mind of you all the time. Okay, no question? Okay, we recite the ending vows and then I will let you go. At the back of the recite, Heart Sutra, we have a ending vows. Living being or innumerable, I vow to save them all. A flexion or endless, I vow to erect them all. The Dharma Dao uncountable, I vow to study them all. The Buddha ways in excels, I vow to attain it. I vow that the merit and virtue from this will go everywhere and reach everyone, so that all of us and all living beings will realize the Buddha way. Okay, thank you.